everybody. It is slightly beyond the appointed hour, so I'm going to go ahead and call our meeting to order and open us with prayer. Let us pray. Almighty, gracious, and loving God, I pray for those gathered here tonight and for the business before them. I pray for a spirit of insight and wisdom, a spirit of courage and joy. May they lay the foundation for a vision for this church as it moves forward in Jesus' name. Amen. And our clerk is noting our role as to several folks.
We do have a quorum.
We do have quorum. Very good. I'm going to go ahead and mention Gina Villafana texted me this late afternoon, and Raphael does have COVID. So she's not going to be here. She's going to get herself tested. So that was the last minute piece there. You see the agenda before you. Are there any additions? Something you wish to put on there? Now I'll accept the motion to accept, proceed to accept the agenda. I see the motion. Second, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All right. And now, the deacons, I need you all to vote to give elders' voice on matters relevant to the deacons. Have a motion, second, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All right, now for the elders. Need you all to vote. Okay. Have a motion, second, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay, good. Everybody can talk. You've seen the minutes that were sent out earlier last week. But getting the last minute reviews you have of the state of the joint officer meeting of last week and congregational meeting of a few weeks before that. Okay, we can accept them. Have a motion to accept them. See a motion. Second, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay, good. So, pastor's report. And again, especially at times like this, it's letters and emails and phone calls that I end up making a lot. As I said, I didn't miss a bill visitation, but I did. Last week I was going to go to see Gloria, and I did get a chance to do that when they had the visitation. Continue to keep her in your prayers. Among those folks within my network, continue to do that by Zoom. The Mesquite Ministerial Alliance began to meet last month, and they're meeting this November 19th. I haven't been to a meeting yet, so see how that goes, but that's back on track. Our Presbyterian meeting is canceled, and as I looked at the Presbytery website, it's not going to be until May that they're scheduling any meetings. So they're doing, got a commission of Presbytery handling a lot of the business. Had a great opportunity to drop off the Halloween bags for some of the children. Sheila and Aaron did some, and that was a great treat to do. Projects there, Stewardship 2020, working on Advent Christmas, finished work on the website. I thought it was going to be up today, and it's not. Still emailing and saying, what else do we need to do? But anyway, there's that. Next Wednesday, the Committee on Committees will be meeting by Zoom. So I hope to have that work finished out pretty soon. And for continuing education, just a short, kind of, I don't know if pep talk's the right phrase for this, but wrote some notes to myself, for you all, kind of looking ahead. That for this year, this of course is our November meeting. We'll be meeting in December, and just encouraging you all to finish strong. I'm particularly thinking those who are rotating off. It's just a couple more meetings, but encouraging to do that. That at this time, in the life of the church, it's important for our strong officers as we begin. Whenever the rebuilding process takes place in the coming year, it's very important. I believe very strongly in the role of teaching elder, working with the ruling elders with the session. And again, so just encouragement to you all to be working just to finish strong. Encouragement to myself to finish out the year well. And the importance of our leadership. So that's not really a pep talk for today. You see the membership report. From last month, we went in number 437, and tonight opportunity to receive a new member.
Always good.
So we could speak from the over there, yes.
You can speak wherever you want to, Pat.
Well, I think I'd rather not climb the stairs.
Okay, if you just you can speak from there, then just and you, for speaking, you can take off your mask for that to make sure it's easy to hear. Yes. Okay. Just tell us a little bit about yourself. What brings you here? Just very, very, very brief. Does that?
Okay. Well, I'm Patty Kim, and of course, until COVID hit, we were attending here pretty regularly. My husband Stephen Kim is with me tonight. We moved here over a year and a half ago now, from the Shreveport-Bossier area. Cotton was exactly where we lived, which was east of Bossier City. We lived there 23 years. A long time, just as long as my husband was in the military, because he was in the Army for 23 years in retirement. He served as a chaplain. He's a Presbyterian minister, retired, honorably, and therefore he cannot join the church. I'm joining the church. And it's a pleasure to do so. I know faces of a lot of people, names are very, very difficult for me to come by. So forgive me if I don't know your name, but I do recognize faces. We live in Garland, East Garland. We have three children, Christopher, who lives with us, Jonathan and his wife live in Ohio, and we have a daughter, Mary, who lives in Shreveport. We have two grandsons, one's 16 and 14. Amazing that they are so old. It makes me feel really, really old. However, at Broadmoor Presbyterian Church in Shreveport was my last, that's where I'm currently a member, and I'll be transferring my membership from there. I probably joined that church around, I don't know, 2008, I think it was. So I was with them for quite a while. I served with the women. I served as a session member most recently, which, you know, with us in the military, we moved around so very much, didn't have an opportunity to really be tied to a church. But when they asked me to serve on the session, I thought, oh my goodness, I've never been asked to serve on the session, but it was an honor to do so. And here, as I said, we've lived here a little over a year and a half now, and we're just getting by. You know, COVID came along, and that changed our lives. About ended everybody's world, of course. And we're still upended, more or less. So we just go day by day. And we do want to start coming back to church. I talked to Renee this week, and, you know, making a reservation. I'm going, oh, really? We saw that on the signboard one time when we drove by. But she said, you could probably come to any of the services, and we have room to sit. So therefore, we're looking forward to coming back into the building of the church and becoming active if we can, of course. So I'm just pleased to be here, my husband as well, and he gave me his blessings tonight on the way over here, and gave me go ahead. So it's sometimes a step ahead to go into a new community, meet new people, leave lots of friends behind, of course, in a church. And one that we love dearly, and I know we're going to love this one dearly as well. So thank you for allowing me to speak.
Well, thank you very much. I have a motion to receive. Okay, a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All right, moving along then. And you all can stay as long as you wish or go home when you wish.
I think we'll go home.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Yes, yeah, happy Veterans Day.
You got a free meal at Applebee's. Okay, we'll see you all around Sunday.
Okay, good. Thank you.
You'll see in your packets the latest calendar updates, the month at a glance, and weeks at a glance, and that which is past is in italics. So So we are moving along. Also got an update from City Mesquite Planning and Zoning Commission notice of public hearing. And I just indicated that we were okay with the subdivision. If you look on the back side, you might get a better picture of what area the name to which they have access. Some of that they won't be able to use because it's in that floodplain, just like we can't use. But you'll see here everybody who's been notified. And if you look at that corner, that's where the nursing home is. And the Seventh-day Adventist Church is here. And that's the property for us in advance. So just kind of an idea of back it up for us. Task force updates. Calling back church task force will be zooming soon. But just note again that from the last meeting that gatherings in large spaces, i.e. the sanctuary and Wilbanks Hall, are permitted. And the youth are going to be having a movie night on Saturday night. And the Presbyterian women did a combination live and Zoom meeting. The evening circle did, I believe.
No,
yeah.
It was just live.
There was three of us.
Okay, but anyway, that is allowed, and we'll be looking to the coming year. Nothing really to report from safety task force. They're doing their job. As for hosting, churches, Mount Sinai, of course, is back to meeting with us, and I had lunch with Eddie today. So we're continuing to our monthly contacts. We now have the second page in the life of the church and finance. And Richard, if you would come up, please. And we have a financial report and updates from stewardship work group on the stewardship campaign.
Thank you, Jones, and good evening. The financial report is in your packet. There's actually three parts of it I want to call your attention to. The first is the monthly financial report, year-to-date financial report. We'll be just presenting information. There's no action that's going to require anything tonight. But if you look for this is for the month of October. The receipts were $317,424. The expenses or the disbursements were. I'm sorry, because that was the year that the first column, current month, $18,647. And then the disbursements were a little more than that, $23,648 for a deficit of about $5,000. However, the next column is the year to date. Year to date, we are at $317,424. And for the income and the disbursement, for $276,000. So that leaves us a year-to-date surplus of about $40,000 or an ending balance of $105,673. If you look at the little summary down there, the 43-week average of income has been $7,381. What's needed by the budget is a little less than $6,700. So we are year-to-date ahead for 10 months. That's the first part of the report. Do you have any questions or comments on that? The second part is the proposed budget, and this is for your review. So what we've done on this budget is based on the pledges that have come in for this campaign, the stewardship drive. The budget is actually matching, the 2021 budget is matching the 2020 budget. If you look on the back, it's $346,673, which is virtually what we had for this year projected. That will be the same for 2021. And that budget, Jones, will be voted on in the December meeting.
Right. This is for your information, for you to just chew over, review, ask questions now or between now and then, and the official action will be taken in December.
Yes. Do you have any questions or comments on the proposed budget as it's presented now? And that budget will be watched as we go through it, as pledges are through the year for justice to be made. And the last part, here's a summary of the pledge. I want to thank Renee for putting this together. The part I want to call your attention to, of course, is our area, the officers. Number of officers is 37. 21 have actually made their pledges for a total of about 57% of us as officers have pledged. And that amounts to about 18% of the budget. So, of course, our goal is that all the officers in the church do make a pledge of whatever amount you are able to do. So if you have made your pledge for 2021, thank you very much. If you have not, we ask that you carefully consider what your pledge might be, if you can make such a pledge, and then get that turned in. Do you have any questions or comments about the pledge summary? No questions or comments, Judge. So I guess we'll get back to the judge.
Thank you. All right. Moving along then, property update. You want to share about David?
Not a whole lot to report on. We're doing small jobs here and there that pop up, getting those resolved. One thing we do want to bring up is the ticket scene. We're scheduling that for December 5th, Saturday at 9 a.m. So if whoever's able can come help us put it up. And also understand there's going to be some other storage items for the decoration for Christmas that we can put up as well, so that shouldn't take too long.
Okay, thank you. Good. I'll go ahead and speak about that. The talk with Adrian, and this week, next week, we'll finalize the schedule, but after Sunday, the 29th, Harriet will come in and this will go, but it'll be down to the 29th, but after that, and this sanctuary will be decorated. And we'll have the tubs for this room brought in, and then people can sign up during the week to come in and say, I'll put this up, I'll put that up. I mean, she'll have a list of who to do what. So you may come in for an hour and do a couple of things, but then you won't be overlapping. And then by the end of the week, it should all be up so that on Sunday the 6th, whether you're here or watching us on YouTube, you'll see the sanctuary prepared. But that Saturday, the 5th, when they're setting up the nativity scene, all these empty tubs will be here, and they'll take them upstairs. So that's the short version of how that's going to be done. So worship is next, and originally worship was scheduled to meet by Zoom last night, but because of what's going on right now, either things are being handled or just irrelevant. Actually, irrelevant is not right. We don't need to worry about it right now. They are relevant. It's just because our circumstances, I should say, poor choice of word there. We will be lighting the Advent candle. We'll have volunteers come forward to light it. The Elder of the Day and I will do the script. Linda Fricke is getting people for 11 o'clock, and I'm handling the other two services because I have an idea who's pretty regular at those. Again, that'll be part of it coming forward. That piece will be done. But again, we won't be having our cantata. We won't be having the handbills. And all those things that we usually have and things we'll be talking about are not taking place this year. So that's kind of sad. But we'll be Zooming about some things in January. And I'll be in touch with you all about that. Important to discuss. And also working on Ben is working on the special pre-recorded Christmas Eve service that will be sent out on the 23rd. And working on the live Christmas Eve services, that first one will be sent out. And like I said last month, it will be available. So we're working on that. And I keep saying, we are one day going to honor Peter Allen. So I'm just keep that on the agenda, keep it in front of us. Christian education. Any particulars?
We are working on a production to take the place of the children's program that we took out, and it will be coming to you via YouTube in early December. We're excited about that. And the youth are planning a movie night, or we plan a movie night for the youth, with all regulations going. I don't know, Aaron, if you wanted the same thing. More about that. It's this Saturday. And the youth are doing the Wreaths Across America. I know that information has gone out. So, and we have our Steve Lee, I think, doing a fantastic job with his Sunday school. And youth Sunday school and children's Sunday school. So we're keeping up.
And along those lines, I'm learning a little even more technology. Steve recorded from home the lesson and sent it to me. I just got Dropbox. Sent it to me with Dropbox, and I figured out how to upload to YouTube from Dropbox. So, I'm kind of proud of myself. I was over there about an hour, not even assuming the other day. And then I'm like, yes, I did it.
Can I add one thing?
Sure.
Usually the city committee prepares goodie bags for the kiddos at Peach House. And this year they actually recommended we not do that. We didn't want to do that for exposure purposes. So we are collecting and we're going to send a donation, and they're going to be able to buy 2 gift cards per child. That's our goal. So anyway, we're taking donations with them.
When do those donations have to be in by?
The next couple of weeks. So we want to get it down to the campuses by the first week of December. So
we just put it in the office?
Yes, and Renee can collect you then, collect in some of the office and stuff. So, or you can go online and designate CD for Peach House bags if you like. Thanks, Renee, too, for doing that. Appreciate it.
And outreach, just kind of getting out of head. I know that in terms of committee on committees, working hard to put together that committee for next year and ready to really rock and roll when we are back to some degree of normalcy. If there is at work and congregational care, if there is a need, we can address it. But some of the traditional things that they have handled, we have not had. With mission, you've got your benevolence update. We are on track. And have been able to give more than, well, we were giving basis on the 2019 basis. We've been able to fill that, and we've also been able to give out of the extra that we had wanted to give this year. We were doing well, and that's one reason October was a little lower, because we did some big giving right then. As it was mentioned that already in November, some monies came in that did come in October. So we actually starting in November very well. The 100 can challenge, we're at 99 cans after 2 Sundays. Oh yes, I'm good. We're at 99 cans right now, it's up until 2 Sundays, so we're really doing very well with that. And Renee, you want to share?
Yeah, I just wanted to say thanks to all that gave for the Thanksgiving baskets. We gave more money this year than we ever had on Thanksgiving baskets, or at least in the 7 years that I've been. So, that's great, wonderful.
Okay, let's make sure to put that in the newsletter. Yeah, poor Renee. After she gets to go to these packets, then she turns right around and starts to work on the newsletter. So it's always something. Yes, Kay.
I just wanted to let them know Mesquite Social does it by poundage, not numbers. So I just wanted to let everyone know last month's contribution was 130 pounds,
okay.
Which is excellent.
All right. Very good. Person, anything else on mission, Larry? Anything else to share on mission? We're good, okay. Diane and personnel.
Can I do it again?
Yes. But you take your mask off to speak, so it'll be easier for us to hear.
Y'all have a page, the initial last page in the packet that has the voting for the down. And it's just in the
I don't have that back.
Go one over. Next to last. Not the last page, it's the next page from the last.
Hold on.
Yes.
Oh, there it is. No wonder I couldn't find it.
It's up there in the corner. Next to last page. It comes from the committee, so it's not required. So that is the does not require a second. It comes from the committee, so we're in discussion. If there's any discussion, otherwise we can take the vote. All right, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All right, so moved. All right, as I said, okay, fellowship. Once we can meet again, ready to party. We got a schedule. Once we can start doing that. Not much to report there. And like I said, with the website, we've been back in touch with Jared, and we're hoping to be up by today. Anyway, so I'll continue to pester about that. Is there any old business? We're really moving quick.
The website was the only thing, I think. I say the website was the only thing.
And then here's a request from Presbyterian Women, and I'm going to read what Barbara Follinsby said. Just, hello, Jones. The Presbyterian Women group is planning on sending Christmas cards to our deployed military troops. I was told by Grace Presbytery that I would need to get the approval from our session. The cards need to be mailed by the end of November, so I'm wondering if we might be able to get approval for the next session for this project. Let's get them out before Thanksgiving. So we just basically need to formally have approved that they do the card. So I see a motion and a second. And one of the discussion on that, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay. We can get to it. And that really is the end of our agenda. This has been a very light meeting. Our next meeting will be December 9th. I'll be inviting our officers-elect to attend that meeting. And, hey, Ben, thank you so much.
I made it.
And a bless your heart, because we're getting ready to dismiss.
I got the
refrigerator. I'm sorry, did I have a question?
I just noticed.
Oh yeah, that last sheet was not supposed to be in the packet. That was one of the check. And nothing secret on there. That was like a checklist to prepare, make sure these items. The refrigerator gave us a bit of a scare the other week because I went to get some ice for my drink, and there's like water was in the thing, so I dumped it all out, got it all mopped up, and I called Aaron or emailed with Aaron. Excuse me. He checked it. He cleaned on the coils. Talked to David about it, emailed with David about it, and it's working now. So I don't know if it just overheated, they're not being cleaned back there. He did the refrigerator thing to get it going. So at first I thought, oh my gosh, we have to get a new refrigerator. For all I know, it's whatever, didn't close the freezer thing well. But that was, when I was preparing that, we were in the midst of, do we need a refrigerator or not? Turns out we don't. But good eye on that. It may be not immediately, but it may be something to be watching. I think Eric said it's been there since he's been a member. So, so it may be. Of course, I'll say too, we are still using our home. Really, let me share this. The Maytag washer that I bought in 1994. We are still using. So. Okay, if that concludes our meetings, mentioned Committee on Committees is meeting November 18th by Zoom. Our next meeting will be December 9th. Entertain the motion that we close.
So moved.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Well, let me pray us out though, okay?
Yes.
Awesome, mighty, and merciful God, I give thanks for all gathered here. I pray for stillness and peace as we all close our business, as we head to our homes, and as we prepare for bed. I pray for safe travel and rest that restores. In Jesus' name, amen.